Alright. All I did today was take out the amps, clean up all my stuff today, and rerun everything. Let's see if I can just get a better angle. I can't wait to get a camera. This thing doesn't give me no nothing. Sorry, I'm still working on this, trying to mount stuff up and learn. What if I do it over here? Well, damn, that's a whole lot better. There we go. Now, like I was trying to say, everything is all taped up. Power wire, ground wire, everything is taped. Redo all of this, needs to be redone. Clean everything with some wire loom. As you can see, all the amps are out going. I already mounted them up on some wood that I've cut. And I'm just about to do a little test fit. So we're going to do a test fit. See if I can give you a better angle when I put it in yonder. Let's see, can that work? Well, I'll be damned, it can work. Oh yeah, this will look very good. This will look very good. One of the bad part is that the kicker, you can't, the power and ground is on this side. That means that the kicker where it's flipped over, I don't like it, but it is what it is. Everything else is good. This will be a little something. It's better than what I had, tell you that much. There's all some spare wood, all these edges will be cleaned. A lot more to do to this. Like I said, I wish I could have, I didn't run everything the same. So my ground is on that side and the power. So kicker isn't facing up. Oh well, it is what it is. But these bad boys look good right there. Very good. So I'll be having one 200x2 is gonna run these 4 6x9s. I may have the other one running my components. 2 6.5. This, the only reason why I put this one, because I blew the tweeter for these. Got this online, put a base blocker on it, it sounds clean. Also, I got the regular tweeter in here. So, hey, mind your business. I'm working here. Yeah. Now, I already got a ground on one side. Just ground is okay. I got to run one. It's a long ass ground. I might just have to chop it. I don't need that much. Matter of fact, this is enough for both sides right here. Goddamn. Hold up. Let's see. Hold up. Go back. Shit, hell. That's enough ground for both sides. I even gotta... I could chop this in half. I don't even need to use all this damn wire. I mean, I need to use all the wire. I need to use all the extra wire for one. Where is my choppers? God dog, it is in the back of the truck. Shit. All right. Ow. this is gonna be a ground for that side. I'll be running that ground under here, under the same spot I did with the other one. So let's go back to the back and grab my materials real quick. Gotta have materials, bro. Oh, the sun is on that side, it's bright as fuck. There we go. Plenty of things like these. I only got one ground. That's all I need. One more ground. Man, I keep leaving the damn wallpapers behind. I need to find an app for time lapsing. And still using welding cable. This is just a smaller. This would be like a 4 gauge. Look how big that shit is. Nope, not gonna fit. Different size. Can't get the job done if you ain't got the right tools. Yeah. Snip off the extra. I used to solder them in, but I don't like them. I don't do that no more. I smashed the shard of it. Somebody say, oh, it's better to solder it. I'm not a fan of soldering. I'm not a big fan at all. When I talk about solders, I'm doing something small. Soldering big stuff. I don't care to solder big stuff. That's some other point. The gorilla squeeze on that thing. Yep, that ain't going nowhere. It's good enough. Ain't gonna be nothing major. I could always take it back off and smash it down with something heavy duty later on. I'm just making my pieces for right now. Today's wire day. That's it. Clean up wires and make everything look good. That way I can go backwards and redo everything else. That'll work. Chop this in here. prepared. If I leave my dikes, I didn't drop. Oh, my tissue. Lose these damn dikes faster than hell. That's gonna look good. I'm not gonna heat it up now. I'm just gonna keep it like it is. That's just making water today, that's it. That's one round. And I also need to do one for the other one. I have a lot of extra cable. This is an extra cable for positive. I'm gonna wrap this in wire loom. Is my phone still recording? The show is. I didn't know. I'll be damned. So, I guess I charge it good. One. First thing to make sure I got the right. I got the seven. Well, we got two of these left, and that is exactly all I need, literally. Time to make some more orders, man. Time to make some more orders. Gotta keep your material in stock, bro. I'm lucky I got material right now. I would've been stuck. I'd have to do a part two of wiring. I don't want to do part two of wiring. That's too much time. Which I wouldn't mind doing part two of wiring, because then I'd be showing a little further. So yes, while I'm doing this wire situation, I don't know how to fast forward this stuff yet. I want to learn how to do that. I have no idea how to do that. I need to get with some buddies and find out how to, is it called time lapse? If I'm right, if I'm wrong, let me know. That'll work, it's enough wire. The other one's a little bit small, I'm not worried about that. I run this exact same wire in my Suburban for my highs, and it is very strong. I have no problems at all. All you gotta do is inspect your equipment. Just keep up with it, so. Inspect. At least once a month, just go back and check all your screws and stuff, man, you know? Especially if you got a lot of music, be rattling everything. You don't want nothing to just fall apart and catch fire or something. Or just get real hot and cut off and damage your equipment. I know a lot of folks don't have any kind of coverage for those who be abusing systems. This might not work. God dog it. I got some wire loom to put on top of this. I don't want to do it like that. Gotta have the wire loom, man. You know what? Hell. So while I'm doing this, I'm actually running out of material. This is bad. I don't like it. It's not good. I thought I had enough. I've used a lot of the material. A lot of my material I've used in other cars or in my own truck. And I'm slacking, bro. Man, he's a lot of material. It's time to re-up on the material right now. Crap. Well, I'll go ahead and do this pause, bro, because I need to get my stuff together. I'm not organized. It's not enough. Might not feel like I know what I'm doing. Alright, so we back with the cleaning up the wires, man. Cleaning up the wires. That power over there, I got a power. Needs to be, got some fresh loom. I think the last time I was messing with this one, if I can get back there, when I was playing with it, I don't remember if I ran out or not. No, I didn't. I just didn't have the whole thing sticking out. So I gotta get this looking better. I'm going to reloom this whole thing. The fuse, make it look better. I may redo this fuse box just because it can look better, I can do better. But for now, I got to redo this wire. I got to redo it. It's a must that it has to be redone. Bruh, I need to invest into a camera. Holy moly. I ain't the best. Alright. I'm back. Same setup. We back to the small things. Definitely gotta do some cleaning. Small cleaning. Remove these amps back out. Get this amp back out. Do all some work here. Clean this up. Clean all that up. And I might pick these amps up, put some lights under them. I had to pick this kicker up with some little pieces because of this side. I got these little adapters and they look good and they're bigger for what I got, the welding cable. So I want to tuck them. They sit straight down. And I had to flip them around, I think, or sideways, or whatever. They work. They do good. I have no power draw. Can't feed it more than what it needs. It's always good for any app. So, for the good news, take a break. Right now it's break time because all the loom is done. Wire loom is done. Well, not done. Let's say I got a bunch of the tips and these pieces, like right here. Still gotta get some heat strength for the grounds, and everything is loomed up. Got my ground, got my power. Need some red loom, red heat strength for these. I got some more speaker wire for this, because right now I have some cheap ass power wire. It's cheap. Got some new CCA wire, not new, but some good wire, better than what I have already. And my remote wire, everything is in loom, bro. Nothing's exposed. It'll be a clean job. Very clean job. So, just wait till the end. This is getting exciting. This is part one, I'm gonna say. Part one of just wiring. We just wiring, showing stuff, doing stuff. Rewiring everything. Cleaning it up. Didn't like how I dipped it. I gotta make this thing awesome. Very awesome. She's coming along. She is coming along. Oh yeah. What up, YouTube? Mr. Drummer is back. And I got good news and I got bad news, but I'm going with the bad news first. So, you know, everybody gotta invest into, you got an old truck, gotta invest into it. I got a problem with it. Besides the music, that's still going on. It's still clean.
I'm still messing with it. I hadn't stopped it. So got into work, I think the 2 days ago maybe. Found out I'm riding. I hear a noise in the back. It's irritating the hell out of me. And it sounds like someone's rubbing. And I mean, drums are new, shoes are new, brakes. I've redone the whole front end, from tie rods to, I redone the entire front end, fellas. I mean, like I said, tie rods, bearings, rotors, calipers. Cause you know, I got 26s on it. You can't, if you do it, you gotta do it right. You can't go half-assed from none of it. Everything is still factory. I didn't upgrade them to heavy duty, but it'll give me some time to finish the rest of the project. But I don't drive it as much, so there's no point in putting heavy stuff on it that I can still handle the truck. I do have some small transmission problems. You know, a couple of engine things I'm doing to the engine itself. Just not doing that yet. That's really just some, whatever project I start on it, I want to start and finish. So, but besides that, I found out that my wheel in the driver rear, I can see my mirror is wobbling. And I'm thinking, yo, man, I hope I ain't got a bent rim. Because it's hard to find 26s for budget. So, excuse me, my niggas. It's hard to find 26s on a budget. Very hard. For anybody that's selling some for that truck, buying some brand new is very pricey, especially on 26s. Because I don't like buying some, but the cheapest things you could buy is black rims. I don't like buying something already polished or whatever. Unless it's a flat silver or chrome. I don't like black. For no vehicle, no rims. I don't like black. It's just too easy. It's easy to bind in. It's too, everybody else is doing it. I don't want to do what everybody else is doing. So, like I said, so I see my back wheel on side to side. Noise got louder and louder and louder. Like, bruh, I'm already riding to work. I got a long ride. I'm halfway there. Well, might as well keep on going. So, I get to the gas station right before work. So I decide, let me go to the back and let me shake the rim back and forth. I mean, I'm shaking the tailgate, you know. Not the tailgate, but I'm shaking the back, like, you know, side to side. You hear clucking noises. Coop, 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 coop. Well, there's good news and bad news. Good news is, rim is not bent. Bad news is, the differential, you know, the axle bearings in the back are gone. I mean, the guy that I got the truck from, they was pulling a horse trailer with. I forgot about that. Maintenance, regular maintenance, you know. All I could do now is just go up with a heavier duty, knowing that I got, transmission is actually new. Transmission and torque converter is new. Drive shaft, of course, too. Yokes and U-joints is on them. Last piece I didn't do was the rear end. Didn't expect, all I did to the rear end was change the fluid, reseal it, put some fluid, no, drain the fluid, you know, put some more sealant, put it back together. I never looked at nothing. But the thing was, I never had the truck running. Now that I got it running, I really even did the fluid change, and now I'm starting to experience that the bearings didn't last long. There was plenty, we used to pull a trailer for horses. So obviously, they wasn't gonna last long. Truck got 192,000 miles, of course. Sometimes you gotta think, but you gotta go through it to find out what the problem is for next time. So, for now, I got it sitting. I'm not gonna mess with that right now. I'm gonna finish the amp rack. I'm gonna do that first. And when I do find time, I might not do it myself. I don't think I want to. I do want to, but I don't. Cause I wouldn't mind a warranty from somebody who does the rigging. So if something goes bad, I can just bring it back to them. And they'll know what to do. And that's gonna be warranty. So I can just drop it off, they fix it, that's it. But no, for sure. I don't want to go budget with the parts, but I may just do that for now. But I will have to upgrade the parts when I upgrade the motor for the power, and you know, some of the transmission is fine. That's all right. I'm not putting that much power to the motor. It's just enough where it doesn't struggle to spin sixes all day. Not spin them, but you know, rattle sixes. So for now, that's what the issue is, and it is parked. It can move. You know, I would be making a video whenever I bring it to a place called Being Immortal out here in Lafayette, and they will be able to tell me what's going on in the back. I wouldn't mind doing it myself, but I work a lot, and I'm trying to give it the air brake, so I don't want to have to mess with the air brake, mess with the truck, mess with the rain. It's a lot of pauses in between. And this YouTube is a lot of work. So, not complaining. Just as tiresome. Today I had a day off. Took a nap. I took a sleep all day. Cleaned up, washed myself, everything. Well, clean, fresh, and not so baggy in the eyes and everything. I'm up. So, this is a good thing you gotta worry about. You gotta sleep. Sleep is important. I've drunk about a good 6-7 Powerade just because. Just stay hydrated, stay clean. You know, wash your hands, sleep with Germex. You know, this corona crap is retarded. This is one of the main reasons why I started this, because I want to, you know, the space between everybody. So, decided to do things myself. Been doing it for a long time, and I hadn't really pursued what I do. I need to do that, and that's what I've started to do. The more you do, the more confidence you start to build. It is fun. Very fun, because now when I do certain things, before I just hurry up and do it real quick, we'll throw it together and it's good to go. Now it's more like a process, as everything goes together, here, there. Now I'm like, okay, now I want it to look good, everything has to look right. So when I present something, you know, if I ever have another customer for myself or music or anything that I'm doing to a vehicle, I can show them, hey, look, this is what I do, how it looks clean, nice and neat, you know. That's how it's supposed to be. So, I'm gonna get to it. I'm going to take out the air brake, which is not connected at all. Amps are on it, but it's not connected. And I'm gonna be moving on. So, let's go get it. Gotta go get it out of the truck. It's dark tonight. It's a late night, but I'm still gonna get it and bring it inside the house. Put it on whenever I can. Show you what I'm doing to it next, cause I got some plans that I thought about. And I think I'm gonna like those plans. So,